Hello and welcome to this short presentation about our work. I am Panagiotis Antoniou from the Lab of Medical Physics of the Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. In the following few minutes, I am going to present you the design and implementation of a semantic framework to annotate digital resources so that they are discoverable, repurposable, and consumable for co-creation of digital mixed reality medical education resources. Back in the 80s, medical data doubled every 2 years. Even though medical data is not the same as medical knowledge, this meant that the doctors of the future had to learn quite a lot back at the 80s. Even more so by 2011, some 10 years ago, medical data doubling was occurring somewhere between 3 and 4 months. Given the crucial nature of medical knowledge and the fact that you need both theoretical and practical knowledge to be good at your job, it is clear that the standard method of teaching was ineffective. That's where technology-enhanced learning came in. Using interactive resources like videos, animations, and even still images, concepts could be conveyed easier. The virtual patient, branching narrative that put the user in the shoes of the doctor and challenged them with actual choice and consequence, has been established and is around for almost 10 years now. Naturally, with the advent of new modalities like virtual, augmented, and mixed reality, a new environment for developing content for medical education emerged. However, another problem substituted the previous one with these modalities. Developing immersive digital content takes a lot of time and effort, so there is a clear content creation challenge. To put things in perspective, I just present this small financial factoid. The healthcare VR market is expected to rise in the span of 30-some billions in some 5 years. This demonstrates how lucrative it is, but it also demonstrates how much of an investment overhead it represents for developing content. Here is where co-creation approaches can shake things up. Co-design and co-creation started off as marketing tools. Instead of boring focus group, the people got to design the product. This led to user investment through participatory knowledge sharing. That's what's key in our case. In healthcare co-creation learning, the expert or the learner are engaged from the content creation stage. They absorb and share knowledge by designing. They put in serious creative investment and thus they add value both in content quality and in development time by reducing it. Everyone who's ever heard of software development this side of the century knows about Agile. It is a highly iterative, agile regarding development times framework for quickly prototyping and iterating software. But what is it doing here? Surely we can't expect our future doctors or nurses to learn programming tools and methods. No. What they can use, though, is a concrete methodology for co-designing immersive educational resources. 4 simple stages: preparation, co-creation, technical facilitation, and prototyping translate core aspects of Agile to help healthcare educators to design and incorporate immersive content in their material. Let's focus a bit on technical facilitation. Medical educators and learners shouldn't have to learn to code. That's not their job. That's what facilitation is all about, providing tools. And, thankfully, tools are available. Most of you are aware of generally available game development platforms like Unity and of semantic frameworks. Semantic frameworks provide metadata, data about data. Annotating 3D models, animation, still images, any kind of asset really, with metadata, we make them machine discoverable and reusable. That way, we can prepare tools and visual editors that our doctors and learners can easily use. That is why we have previously proposed what we call the semantically annotated visual data structure, an integrated data entity that encapsulates both the actual audiovisual assets along with medical interactivity and user experience metadata. The VDS has its branching narrative part, text and links, implemented and described in a previous work, where we had visualized immersive medical education resources in OpenSim and Second Life. The branching narrative part is readily transferable from there. However, moving to XR, what is currently missing is two things. One is the interaction and UX descriptions, such as annotations about the modality of VR or the overall user experience. The other thing missing is the description of the resources in terms of medicine. And here is where medical ontologies come in. Medical ontologies are well-established repositories of rigorously structured vocabularies that describe and interlink medical terms. You might have the liver described with a formal definition, but that is not all. Links to other terms, such as the parts of the liver, would denote a relationship of general to specific or a superset-subset relationship in other cases. This kind of logic and the extended nature of medical knowledge has spawned a lot of medical ontology vocabularies. In order to make things easier, a meta-thesaurus was devised and is available. The Unified Medical Language System, UMLS meta-thesaurus, is a repository maintained by the National Library of Medicine, and it combines many existing biomedical and health vocabularies to enable interoperability between computer systems. So, that UMLS meta-thesaurus is the first part that we are building our taxonomy on. It has all the relevant terms for our level of medical detail in one place and is already formulated and accessible as an ontology. We'll see in a little while how we implement it, but conceptually, this covers the medical part of our needed semantic backend. However, the question remains, what are we linking these medical terms with? Is there a similar framework for user experience? Can we find a rigorous taxonomic representation of UX elements and VR modalities? The answer is probably not. There is a lot of piecemeal work on UX and visualization, gestures and physicality, however, there is no solid framework. That is why we utilize the simple brainstorming design with an expert panel. Educational technologists and medical educators who have used VR resources collaborated on a design for an ad hoc UX-XR hierarchy of terms. And that is what they have come up with. This broad mind mapping of this conceptual hierarchy consists of four large categories. One for the type of virtual environments that we may have. One for the interaction modalities that can exist. Another one for the types of interaction in those environments. And finally, one for the type of VR that we could have in this environment. Regarding the virtual environment description, we have identified tabs like movement capacity, which includes stationary, not moving at all, a static environment that you just look around and interact with, point of interest movement from point to point, like in a 360 video format, free movement, like in a 3D virtual environment. We have identified the kind of assets, 3D asset, 3D model, with attributes for position and size, and also the type of virtual environment. Is it a virtual reality lab, a classroom, a VR metaphor like going inside the human body, or a simulation like a surgical one? In the interaction modalities description, we have gaze click and gesture click to denote the different interaction types that you have in devices like the Microsoft HoloLens or the Google Cardboard. You have mouse click for devices like Windows-based computers. You also have the type of interaction that is expected. For example, walking through collider and triggering events, or spatial collision, two items colliding with each other or passing through specific areas. As you can see, this is followed by a platform-specific implementation tab to allow for future extendability in case there is a standard as we develop and integrate this into actual resources and game engines. Regarding the description of the interaction, we have what do the previously described interaction ways, what kind of effect do they produce? We have the select interaction or the activate interaction. The one is different from the other. The select one could just identify a multiple choice questionnaire. The activate could actually begin a series of animation. The move item, something that someone might interact with and move it in the environment. Or the move self, the actual movement of the individual. And also a generic collision interaction. Finally, we reach the VR modalities tab, which describes what kind of VR XR resource we have. We have 360 videos, 3D VR, mixed reality, and augmented reality. Just a quick note, mixed reality is different from augmented reality. In our conceptualization is the difference between the capacity to interact between digital and physical world, while augmented reality is just digital augmentation without fully identifying the 3D space that these augmentations exist in. Now, regarding the technical aspect of implementing the ontology, the extracted UX terms along with the UMLS metathesaurus were transformed to RDF using scores, which allows for hierarchical ordering. The transformation process was technically implemented with the linked pipes extract transform load utility. Data were imported from the mind maps and the ontologies in CSV format. And after the hierarchical classification of the UX concept, the exported RDF file was uploaded to a Virtuoso server. The ENTICE RDF browser was deployed to browse the UX taxonomy and other resources. In the link data.entice.eu, you can access actually this ontology. Mentioning the word ENTICE, I must note that this is an endeavor that was implemented in the context of an overall effort to create reusable, tangible, and intangible anatomy resources in the context of the ENTICE Erasmus Plus Knowledge Alliance program. Our aim is to digitally augment 3D prints and other kind of physical resources with digital enhancements, in order to create immersive and effective surgical and anatomical education. The overall goal is to implement an immersive e-classroom for surgical and overall anatomical education. In that context, the ENTICE core ontology was used to describe educational episodes developed in the context of the ENTICE project, describe the medical terms from the UMLS repository, as we mentioned, and actually link medical terms to UX terms using properties such as virtual environment or VR modality. Now, information regarding the medical terms was the definition, broader and narrower concept obtained from UMLS, and also medical terms were described using scores. This work, as was mentioned before, is the point of entry for actually annotating a resource and creating an integrative visual data structure. The aim is to create an applicable true visual data structure that contains the UX taxonomy, either improvements upon it, the constructed UMLS metathesaurus terms that were integrated in the framework, along with the actual resource, the 3D model or the animation or anything similar, as well as narrative and choice-based architecture like the one implemented in previous work for virtual patients in OpenSim and Second Life. At this moment, the ontology is implemented and prototyped, but not integrated to actual 3D resources, because for that we need to create an initial pool of annotated visual data structures, and we also plan and are in the process of creating applications to consume such resources, both in the form of scenario players, but also of scenario editors that utilize this whole semantic framework. We believe that this work is the final necessary prerequisite for creating a really reusable virtual reality, augmented reality, mixed reality, educational medical resource, as well as creating infrastructure like digital content editors for supporting the authoring of such resources in a co-creative manner. Thank you very much for watching this presentation.